told you you could lose the weight you want without changing what you eat or your portion sizes? Well, you can. A trendy new weight loss method has been getting a lot of buzz lately, and it is called intermittent fasting. I'm dying to talk to you about this. It's not so much about what you eat, it's about when you eat during the day. It's about cycling between periods of eating and plain old not eating. Now, some experts say that this helps consumers take in fewer calories, lowers your blood pressure, improves glucose levels, and even slows down the aging process. There are a number of variations to how you can do this. It's called IF, intermittent fasting. On one option, you can eat only between noon and 8 o'clock each day, which means you're fasting for 16 hours a day. Another option has you eating 4 days out of the week and fasting the other 3 days. That's what our, hold on, that's what you think now. But that is what our next guest, Soumaya Kazi, did. And after losing 50 pounds, y'all, 50 pounds. She's still with us today is nutritionist Joy Bauer and cardiologist and weight loss expert Dr. Louisa Petrie. So thank you both so much for being here.
Hey,
Joy, let me ask you, is this safe?
First, I want to commend you because you have done an amazing job and you look super, and I know your insides are probably doing amazing things as well. It is ridiculously hard, and you've converted this into a lifestyle. I think the majority of people would not be able to follow it the way that you are, but there's another variation that we spoke about, and they talked about it in the Wall Street Journal that's very interesting to me.
You eat for 12 hours. 12.
Exactly.
And you don't eat for 12. That sounds more doable.
It's a window of eating, 12 hours. So if you start breakfast at 8 o'clock in the morning, then you finish dinner 8 o'clock in the evening. And what I like about this, obviously you could shift it depending upon your schedule. You could start at 9 a.m. and end at 9 p.m. What I like is that most people excessively nibble in the evening. We have a big problem with that. So that takes it off the table and it makes you more mindful. And I think even if people just do this as a 1 week experiment, a 12-hour eating window during each and every day,
all right,
it's a great learning
curve.
Here's
my question for you, Dr. Petrie. We've always been told don't skip breakfast, don't skip, because your body believes it's going into starvation mode, your metabolism slows down, and you gain more weight if you starve yourself.
Well, there is a saying that you should have breakfast like a king, and that's for a reason. Your body is trained to process the food more during the day. Your body makes those digesting enzymes and hormones. They are matched to be optimized in the morning. So it is important to do this eating period somehow to match part of the morning. If you do it 7 o'clock or 10 o'clock,
but are you slowing down your metabolism by not eating?
No, absolutely not. It's been shown in studies that it takes absolutely 72 hours for your metabolism to slow down
72.
After fasting. So it's a myth that has to be demystified. That's not true. Actually, intermittent fasting speeds up your metabolism up to 10%.
And reverses the aging process. I mean, like, that's something Jenny Craig cannot promise. I have to tell you, I'm really intrigued by it. I love the thought of it. And, you know, with all, like, the calorie-restrictive, you know, things going on that people swear by, I was really, and I said in the new year, I'm going to try this. And so far, I have not made it one single day. I was trying to just do 12 and 12.
Yeah.
Well, not one single day. Quickly, I got to go.
A lot of people think that intermittent fasting, everybody does intermittent fasting without realizing it. When you go to bed and you go sleep, you're fasting for those 8 hours.
Yeah, but you're asleep.
You're asleep. Of my 36 hours, 16 of those hours, I'm sleeping. So the 36 hours counts as that.
That is not going to happen in my house. I'm going to keep trying, though. Thank you. This is amazing.